There are two types of coastlines. The emerging coastline, which is dominated by degradational, erosional landforms. But again, as I told you, that doesn't mean that there are no depositional features along emerging coastlines, because we know there are. And submerging coastlines, which are dominated by depositional or aggradational landforms. Does this mean there are no degradational, erosional landforms along submerging coastlines? Of course not. You're going to have both types of features, the degradational erosional and the depositional aggradational, along both types of coastlines. It's just that along emerging coastlines, the degradational erosional features tend to dominate, and along submerging coastlines, the depositional aggradational landforms tend to dominate. But you generally get a bit of a mix. These are the ones I want you to know in terms of submerging coastlines in general, coastlines across the planet as a whole, and depositional and aggradational landforms. A beach, I think you know what that is. These are the main depositional features along the coastline. They're made up of sand and other light, loose material. A spit, which is a beach that stretches partway across a bay. This is largely the result of the longshore current, which is the dominant current in an area, dragging the beach out across the bay. A bay mouth bar. This is formed when a beach stretches all the way across a bay, enclosing it. This, by the way, is what Bolsa Chica is about. And a tombolo. A tombolo is formed when a beach stretches out and connects a sea stack to the coastline. There you go. You're going to have both types of features: a sea stack, which is an erosional feature, and a tombolo, which is a depositional feature. It's a type of beach, really. Take a look at this diagram again. Have you figured out what this is? What is this? What is that? I'll give you a hint. It's named after the Greek letter D. See, the river comes down like that, reaches base level here. Deposits its material. There you go. All right. So look now at letter E. What is letter E? Letter E is a beach. What about letter F? Well, when you look at letter F, notice that this is a sea stack, just like these are sea stacks. And this sea stack is connected to the coastline by that beach. What do we call this type of beach that connects a sea stack to the shoreline? Letter F? That would be a tombolo. All right, this is not the greatest diagram in the world. It is a little bit fuzzy, but when you steal something from the internet, you don't always get the greatest. But if you look here, you can see there's a tombolo. I've circled it in that kind of bronze color. What they're calling a barrier spit, which is a spit, you can see the way it's stretching partway across the bay. What they're calling a bay barrier, which is really a bay mouth bar, that's enclosing that thing that was a bay that was once connected to the global ocean. And that allows a lagoon to begin to form, which eventually kind of fills in. This again is happening at the Bolsa Chica wetlands. Take a look on the left-hand side. We've got a beach. Obvious enough, you can see the reason the beach isn't uniform all the way down is because they built this thing right here, which is called a groyne. The idea of this is to keep the beach in place when there's storms, but you can see that it does cause coastal erosion. Meanwhile, the material builds up over here. Then you can see over on the right-hand side, there's a spit being pointed out by the white arrow. You can see the way that comes off that island and hooks out. Now, if you look at this carefully, there's some other things you can discern. You can discern which way the longshore current is moving, which is indicated by the blue arrow. Because if you look at the beaches right here, you can tell the beach is being dragged off towards the left, and you can see the spit is being pulled out into this bay. That's because the current comes in here and moves the sand in a process known as beach drift. This is a bay mouth bar. You can see on the land side of this beach that stretches across those former bays that were formerly open to the global ocean. What eventually happens is this slowly fills in because of deposition and plant growth. Because that area that's no longer directly connected to the ocean becomes brackish water, And in addition to that, it's not subject to that harsh pounding of the waves anymore. Then this is a Tombolo. That's more a rock right there, which is an extinct volcano or the remnants of an extinct volcano. But you can see where the blue arrow is at. The blue arrow is pointing at a beach that's connecting more rock, which is a sea stack, to the coastline. That makes that beach where the blue arrow is at a Tombolo. This is one of the most famous Tombolos in the world, Mont Saint-Michel in France. And Mont Saint-Michel, which is the name of the church, Mont, means mountain. It's built on top of this former volcanic plug, this extinct volcano. But you can see in the foreground, this beach stretches out and connects this sea stack to the shoreline, making that beach right there, where you see the cars are parked there also, a Tombolo.